We are here on the red carpet. I think I'm at a loss for words. Standing right beside Blake Shelton here, Dexter's coach. And I think the first thing I have to ask you is all four chairs turned. All four judges turned their chairs. Were you confident that you would be the coach that he picked for The Voice?
Come on, he's a smart Alabama guy. I knew he was going to make the right decision. You know what? His journey has been, you know, exactly what I thought it would be on this show. You know, from the first time I heard that guy sing, I knew that there was, you know, first of all, there's something special about the guy. You're just kind of drawn to him and you like him. But I knew he was a great singer first and foremost. I didn't know anything about his personality until the last, you know, few months when I started working with him. And I see how hard he works at it and how serious he is about music. But he's not a serious guy. But he works hard at this, and he wants it badly, you know. And I didn't even know that it had a run on American Idol until he was telling me about it. And it shows you, you know, how horrible that show is in particular that he didn't win. I mean, my gosh, what a terrible show that
right?
must be, that American Idol. American Idol show.
We need the boys, right? And he was saying how much you have done for him and how much of an awesome mentor that you have been, the advice to just be himself. Do you think he has taken the advice you've given him?
I guess he has. I mean, you know, people love the guy. They love his singing, but they love Dexter. They love who he is, and that's something that you can't fake, you know. And the fact that he's been able to just kind of be himself and let the cards fall where they may is, I think, part of the reason he's here in the finale. And he did it. You know, who knows who's going to win this thing? All four of these artists are incredible. They all deserve to be here, and that's the best you can hope for, because guess what? No matter who wins, they're all going home tomorrow night, no matter what.
I mean, you have three of the four, though. Are you confident?
Not really. there's a theory floating around here that, you know, the more people you have as a coach in the finale, the more your votes kind of get divided up. And so if you believe in that theory, then Malin's going to win this thing for Team John. I can't accept that. You know, I'd love to
your foot down.
I'd love to see Dexter win that. We're counting on you, Alabama. Come on, Alabama.
We need those votes.
Do this, please. Yeah.
And you're singing with him tonight.
We're singing an old Brooks and Dunn song that every time these duets come up, my contestants, I don't know if they appreciate it or not, but it's always songs that I'm kind of know second nature, and then they end up having to work on them, you know. And so this song is one that was big when I was in high school. It's called Hard Working Man. And it was just, I've always wanted to sing the song, just never had somebody that could kind of cover Ronnie Dunn until Dexter came along.
Perfect candidate for it. Thank you so much for your
Thank
time.
You.
We appreciate you, and
Good
we're
to
excited
you.
To watch tonight. Vote.
Vote. Come on, Alabama.
All right. Back to you guys.